My name is Jérôme Leblay, and I'm the world leading expert on the sculpture Auguste Rodin. In 2015, I received a very interesting email from a young intern working for a foundation in America. This foundation was created in the 1930s by a lady called Geraldine Rockefeller Dodge. And she lent a beautiful neoclassical palace to the city of Madison in New Jersey. And she filled it with works of art from her own collection. The building is now used as the city hall, and they hired this intern, Mallory, to do an inventory of their collections. In the main room of the city hall, where the council meetings are usually taking place, she saw this marble. It was in the corner on a stand, but really completely forgotten. She looked closer, and on the side, she was amazed to see a signature. It reads Rodin. Of course, the name of the famous French sculptor. She couldn't believe it was a real Rodin sitting here in this city hall in America. So she sent me an email to see if it was true. I immediately recognized the work, but I decided to pay a visit to see for my own eyes and authenticate the bust in person. So I traveled to the suburbs of New York, to the city hall where was sitting this bust, an incredible Rodin sculpture that had sat here unnoticed for 75 years. It was a very big discovery, a very big moment of emotion for me and also for the people of the foundation, because for all these decades, they thought it was a copy. And then they suddenly realized it was an authentic Rodin sculpture, and one of a kind, actually. A unique masterpiece of the bust of Napoleon, the only one existing in marble. It was so emotional for me. And I think that for some people of the foundation, it would be one of the most striking moments of their life. It's quite an unusual subject for Rodin. He usually sculpted friends or living people, and very rarely people he never met. So he collected a lot of materials from various sources. One of the very interesting elements in this bust is the inscription on the right side, enveloppé dans son rêve. Enveloppé dans son rêve means in English, draped in his dream. And it's very unusual for Rodin to make a direct comment on his work. What Rodin is wishing to transmit to the audience, to the collector, is that Napoleon was draped in his dreams, dreams of the French Revolution, the dreams of freedom, and the dreams of democracy. On the other hand, Napoleon went too far. He became a dictator himself. So the bust has a lot of intensity, a lot of introspection in it, because Rodin is really trying to show the balance, the moment when Bonaparte is the young general and not yet the old emperor. All the story around this work is exciting and unique. When I unveiled the truth to the foundation, they were definitely shocked by the discovery. For them, it was, at the same time, a beautiful discovery, but also a treasure to protect. It was very emotional and quite a moment.